are now in the in-between period between when Jesus ascended to heaven, which we celebrated on Thursday, right here in this church with the Holy Communion, and the coming of the Holy Ghost. It's kind of an in-between period where the disciples have to once again figure out what it is that they are supposed to be doing in their mission and ministry as members of the body of Christ. The Archbishop of Canterbury, Justin Welby, and the Archbishop of York as well, has asked that during these days, we as members of the body of Christ pray with special intention for the coming of the kingdom of God. As we pray every time we say the Lord's Prayer, "Thy kingdom come." And this is much like what happened with the disciples and the apostles during this 10 days in between Jesus' ascension to heaven and the gift of the Holy Spirit on Pentecost or Whitsunday. Those disciples were told that by Jesus that he would send to them the Comforter. And so they spent time during the next week praying about what that might mean. In your bulletins is a postcard. You saw this last week and you may have received it in the mail as well, inviting you to participate in this week's Thy Kingdom Come activity. We have now, the last 2 days, gathered at 6 p.m. outside in our prayer wall, and we have prayed evening prayer together. A short version of evening prayer, and of course, being good old-fashioned Episcopalians, we have a hard time praying without a book in front of us, or at least in this case, a booklet. On Friday night, we had 12 parishioners. We had a couple of the Olympia Park people join us as well from a distance. They were throwing in their amens, they said. Last night, we had 16 parishioners show up, as well as a couple of parking attendants. And we even had a couple of drunken people on one of those drinking white things who were less than flattering as they rode by. But God bless them anyway. But it's been really wonderful to be out there and to be praying and to be witnessing to the world the power of prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. We've watched the people going across the street to the shows, or walking back and forth, or waiting for the queue line, hesitate. They stop and they look, and in the middle of the prayer, waving people over, and they smile and they wave back. A couple people have stopped and crossed themselves. In that silent moment, they join with us, and they join with the prayers of the saints as we offer up our praise to Jesus and to our Heavenly Father. And I invite you as well, there's a sign-up sheet downstairs if you haven't signed up, to please do so. We'd like to have at least 10 people every day joining us for prayer wall. Tonight I think we have 6 people signed up, and tomorrow night we have 7. All the rest of the week, I think we do have 10 signed up. But we'll take 20. I have 20 copies that we have, we can share. I know it's not very Episcopalian, but we'll share as well. Okay? So please do plan on coming one of the days between now and next Saturday to join us in this prayer effort. And the simplicity of the prayer effort, the wonderful thing about the prayer effort, is that we are praying, we are witnessing by being physically there, and then on Friday night, Martina gave us her 5-minute testimony about being here at St. John's and how her life was changed by Jesus Christ. In a moment of prayer, God changed her life and how she saw the world in a new way. Last night, Joe witnessed, we heard Joe's story about the way in which God has affected him through those he has worked with and those he has counseled over the years, as well as the way he senses the presence of God as he's now going through another battle with cancer. And even in that cancer, he has seen with the eyes of love that the body of Christ is active and is at work. It's a wonderful opportunity for us to gather together and to realize that Jesus hears our prayers and that Jesus loves us and that he loves the next who's about to come into fellowship with him as well. Today's gospel reading, we heard about Jesus on Thursday ascending into heaven, and now we hear that Jesus is going to send the Comforter, God the Holy Spirit. We've talked a lot about the Holy Spirit in the last couple of weeks because it is vital and important that we understand that the third person of the Holy Trinity is active and participating in the life of prayer. He is active in encouraging us. He is active in strengthening us and guiding us so that we can become the saints that we are called to be. We have an idea of who the Father is. I hope we know who Jesus is and that we've chosen him as our Lord and our Master. But God the Holy Spirit seems so nebulous to us, so far off. and quite frankly, a little scary. And yet it is God the Holy Spirit whom this week we are praying in preparation for His coming. We are praying and asking Him to come and shower upon us all of those wonderful gifts that He has continually showered upon the church, that we may have wisdom and knowledge and piety and understanding, that we really may know the love of God and reflect that love to our neighbors and to all those around us. It is by the gift of the Holy Spirit, who we'll talk about in earnest next week on Pentecost on Whitsunday. It is by the gift of the Holy Spirit that we are what we call quickened. We literally are animated with the Spirit of God Himself. God Himself dwells in us by virtue of our baptism, and it is God Himself who is equipping us for this ministry to be the body of Christ. Jesus has ascended into heaven, and by going into heaven, He has gone outside of our space and our time. No longer is He confined to being in one place at one time, right? When Jesus was ministry on earth, He kept to the laws of nature. Well, He kept them for the most part, right? That whole walking on water thing against the laws of nature. But we have no evidence that when Jesus was in Nazareth on a Tuesday, that on the same Tuesday He was in Jerusalem. Or when He was in Galilee, that He was also in Bethlehem. But now, having ascended into heaven, Jesus is more present. He has gone outside of our time and space and by that wonderful reality, by that wonderful grace, He is now present here. He's present across the way at Central Methodist Church. He's present up the street at St. Paul's. He's present in Jerusalem. He's present in Rome. He's present in Canterbury. By going up, by ascending and going outside of our time and space, Jesus Christ is now more present with us than He was those 33 years. And you, by grace, by faith in Jesus Christ, have access to all those gifts. He is present in His holy word. He is present in the fellowship of the saints. He is present in the sacrament of the altar. And He's present in the life of prayer. And we have the ability to access Him in all of those ways. And I pray and I hope that you do. Tonight at 6 o'clock, we gather once again for prayer wall. And we might be under umbrellas, according to the forecast. If it's really stormy, we'll come inside. But I did order 50 umbrellas today, printed with the St. John's logo, will be here on Tuesday. So if we get more rain the rest of the week, we'll have those umbrellas, right? But we'll gather together and we will pray and we will praise and we will thank God for the gift of Jesus Christ. And we will ask Him to be known more and more and more by us and by us. As you may know, our parish motto is wonderfully simple. It is to know Christ and to make Him known. May God grant us the grace through the life of prayer, through the scriptures, through the fellowship, through the sacraments, to know Jesus more and more, and be filled to overflowing by His grace. May we make Him known in Detroit, in our neighborhoods, and in the world, for He is Lord. In the name of the Father, and the Son,